Welcome back to another episode of the Mindcrack Podcast. Is this number 13? Did I miss
episode
one?
Episode 13.
Lucky for some.
Yeah, you weren't in episode 12.
Oh, yeah. I feel so out of the loop. Our guest today is nobody.
Yeah. Technically 14, isn't it? Since we have a lost one somewhere out there in the world.
That's right.
I didn't forget to record.
So yeah, we got the four of us. This is the first time since the very first one, I think, that we've all been together and had no guest.
Yeah, for a couple of weeks now.
So there better not be any complaints about,
oh, you guys never have a guest on.
Where's this Etho?
Is only the second time it's ever happened.
Where's Etho?
Where's Kurt?
We should have had Generic come on and do his Etho impression for like 20 minutes and just
and just say terrible things.
Yeah.
Swear nonstop.
Blow people's mind.
Ew.
All right, so in the news, our beloved server has gone to a snapshot, Good. You pulled the trigger on that.
Mm-hmm. Well, we all made the decision together.
No, you,
that's true. You pulled the trigger. I totally agree with the decision, by the way.
It's like you're blaming me, but I agree.
I think everyone on the server, I don't think we've heard any complaints from people on the server.
No,
you know, and there was some talk in the Reddit about how, well, this is going to alienate your audience and people aren't going to watch. And I've noticed an increase in views across the board, it seems like. So, and I think people are more excited to play because they're able to play with the new stuff. And mm-hmm. I don't know, I just think it's all around better.
I think your logic is sound, that it's all old hat by the time it comes down to.
Well, yeah, I mean, like, you got all these other YouTubers who are just constantly posting the snapshot every week, and then as soon as we come out, when the legitimate release comes out, it's like, I don't even want to do anything with it, because I've seen and I've heard everything that's new now.
Yep. I mean, and it's, I mean, there were so many people on the server doing their snapshot videos, too. Mm-hmm. It's not just, like, YouTubers in general. It's people that you're friends and talk to on a regular basis, and it's like, they're having a conversation, and you're just like, shh.
Right. I never did any of the snapshot stuff, but I could imagine guys like Doc and B00 not even really wanting to play on the server because they've got all these new and exciting features, but they can't put them into use.
Yeah.
On our server. But now they can.
I was actually worried that they might get a little mad at that because they were doing the, because I mean, B00 was doing his like little sneak peek or whatever, and Doc was doing his as well, but.
Well, he could still do it. We're not exactly thorough in what we show.
Yeah.
Hey, look, it's a bat. You're cute. Next episode. Oh my God, it's a bat.
No. I mean, I think that's what I think we did not want to go snapshot and then suddenly, you know, go into these like tutorial snapshot style videos either.
No, that's not fun.
I know that's why Beef and I kind of teamed up that one day too, so that we weren't both putting out similar videos. You know, here's a bat.
Yeah, they're adorable.
I just want to tame one. Seriously, they should make cages where you can put a bat in.
Well, you can make a cage with like iron bars and stuff. The problem is the bats despawn.
Yeah, I bet they won't eventually though, or there'll be a way to like give them a, I don't know, a berry or something.
I think.
What are they, fruit bats?
I think.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get really. Really boring and technical here, but they should include 24-bit PNG support. So you've got alpha channels because the edges of the wings are really like bitty and shitty.
Wow, what a nerd!
It'd be nice to have, a nice blend. Well, you know, that's my job.
They seem small though. It doesn't seem they almost don't fit for me in Minecraft.
Yeah, I have to agree. The styling and stuff, it doesn't. It's not what I would have pictured them to look like.
No, not blocky enough, are they?
No.
Yeah, they need to be a little more blocky. Like they could have made like the dragon has those blocky wings.
Mm-hmm.
I think maybe if they did something like that, it'd fit in a little better.
Do you know what? Every week, all we do is just sit here and bitch about the bits that they've put in.
No, we're not bitching. We're just
offering
constructive criticism. Guess, maybe.
Yeah. We love the game, obviously.
Yeah. I really love the bats. And this, I love, you know what? For me, this has been the most enjoyable update to Minecraft, I think, since Halloween update.
And we're close to another one.
Well, I know. That's what's funny to me is this is supposed to be a Halloween update. So it's like something happens in the weather or something around October, and programming really, really comes around.
Their juices the nights draw in Sweden, don't they?
Well, yeah, days become shorter. You're kind of stuck inside, and it's also cold over there, so.
Winter draws on, as my gran used to say.
Well, speaking of bad grandmother.
Your grandma talked to you about drawers?
No, not winter draws on.
That's what I heard. Like, winter underwear? Your grandma talked to you about winter underwear.
Cold outside, little bash. Get your winter drawers on.
Make sure your penis is warm.
And that, gentlemen, is the joke.
Oh, nicely done. Oh, yeah, so we love the game. And speaking of how much we love it, there's 30 more biomes we would love to be added to the game. So change it some more, Mojang.
I think that's really the next update that needs to happen, though. Don't you guys feel that way?
I honestly agree. Like,
so for people who don't know what we're talking about, there's an article in PC Gamer that, I guess, is it just regular?
It was on Reddit at first. It showed up on the Minecraft Reddit, and it was just a guy who created 30 different biomes. And
Using like existing.
Yeah.
Some of them are pushing it a little bit, but there's some good ones in there, definitely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I like the Mesa.
I was about to say the Mesa. That's something I've always wanted because I like that part of the United States too, like the Arizona, Colorado, Red Rock, desolate.
Well, the one thing I don't remember seeing in that Reddit post was an underwater biome.
Yeah, you're right. There wasn't
Which is what I want next. Please.
And stuff like that. Yeah. Because especially, you know, once they added the big oceans, it really felt like there needed to be something out there.
They're just empty, vast, empty wastes of space, really.
I think right. We talk about the oceans every podcast.
Well, we'll continue until we get our point across.
Mojang, get to it, seriously.
Pay attention.
Oh, man.
But yeah, there's some really cool biomes in there. And like I said, I started posting the topics in the description, so go check it out.
Mm-hmm. I think one of them was like an ice mountain. It looked like it would be worthless to some extent, but it would still look cool. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Glaciers, yeah.
I'm looking at them now. Yeah, they look really, really good.
I like the safari one too.
Make sure you check that post out, guys.
Yeah, seriously. And tell Jeb to get to it.
Mm-hmm. So MySpace is in the news.
I did not read this one, but I'm just shocked.
Apparently it's undergoing a redesign. Can't they just let sleeping dogs lie? Huh?
Oh.
Huh?
Wow, way to plug your own Let's Play. Way to do that. YouTube.com/VintageBeef.
Why is Justin Timberlake's face on this article?
Because he owns MySpace.
What?
Yeah.
You didn't know this?
No. That's too damn funny.
It looks like they're going to offer some more integration with Facebook and Twitter and focus more on music. But I think, I don't know.
That's a good idea.
Well, yeah, it like is, MySpace like 10 back years then. Ago. Yeah, that like MySpace just became like a huge place for bands to post their music. But I don't know.
If you're into that, it's nice to have a good place to go where it's all together.
There are other sites now, though.
Yeah, they're a little late to the party. It feels like.
Yeah.
Well, they were quite early to the party, and they got drunk and fell outside, didn't they?
Well, exactly.
Now they staggered back in.
Back in.
I bet it's Justin Timberlake's fault. I want to blame him for some reason. I don't know, I like him, man.
He was everyone's friend, but he just let everyone down.
He had a dick in a box, too.
Wait, Tom did?
No. Well, I don't know. You could call him Tom. He didn't really have a name in that skit.
I don't even think you know who Tom is, do you?
I don't know who Tom is.
Really? He's like, as soon as you, like back then when you created a MySpace account,
he was
instantly your friend.
Wait, was Justin Timberlake Tom?
No.
Oh.
This was the old creator.
What happened to him? Did Tom die?
I don't know.
We should all know he's friends with everybody on the internet. Or was.
They're maybe Justin Timberlake killed him.
Whoa.
I bet so.
We just uncovered a conspiracy.
This, I mean, it's official. It's confirmed. Okay, moving on. Kickstarter is planning on disclosing risks when you donate to people who need
I thought money. They already disclosed that the people don't actually have to give you anything as a result of you giving them money.
Yeah, but I think like what it stems down to is like showing or letting the people know that this game, if it doesn't reach this, amount of money that it won't come out and they won't get their money back.
Yeah, that's not the problem. Because you don't give them the money if the game doesn't,
reach the target. If you don't reach the target.
There was there's a big fuss because there was a woman who wanted to create some videos about women in gaming or something, and then she got all the money she needed, and then she's like disappeared.
Well, hasn't the same thing happened to that company that wanted to do the Minecraft documentary?
Oh, really?
They haven't posted any updates on their Kickstarter since they reached their target.
But they've been around filming though, haven't they?
They
went to Mojang, didn't they?
Yeah, but like the very first video came out in November last year.
Are you talking about the guy that was trying to get money to go to Minecon this year? Like he did the film? Oh, okay.
No. There was this company that was going to do a document. They put out a trailer and everything. It was like a 14-minute long trailer, and it was good, but they needed more money, to complete the production, and I don't think they've updated their Kickstarter in a long time. And another thing happened, there's this YouTuber. I don't know if you guys know The Amazing Atheist.
Oh, yeah.
Well, apparently he wanted to start sort of like a rival YouTube called Not Productive, and he reached his goal, and he hasn't said anything either about anything. So I don't know, man. This Kickstarter stuff, it seems like a big scam to me.
Well, I mean, I think that it's made so that it really can be, because it says whenever you give them the money that they don't have to guarantee that they'll ever finish the project you're backing.
That's wrong.
That's terrible.
Well, they may try. They may spend all their money. They may say, all right, we need $60,000 to make this game. And then you give them $60,000 and they really sucked at planning. And they bought a bunch of alcohol with it and then they didn't finish the game. But they tried.
Maybe that's no excuse. Maybe that's what they have to like disclose. We are alcoholics. We
have to disclose their drinking history.
So Kickstarter is now officially AA.
It seems like there's just no accountability there, though. Really?
I thought everyone knew that already. I guess is where I'm coming from.
Well, I knew about it, but I mean, the stories that Beef just told me are kind of shocking.
But see, now that company he's talking about that did the documentary, I don't think you've got all the facts there, Beef, because I swear I remember them coming to Mojang and they've put out some videos since and stuff like that. I don't know that.
Well, see, I remember watching that trailer, but I haven't heard any other news. And I mean,
yeah,
for something like that, a documentary on Mojang would be pretty big news for it to come out, even like a slight update.
Well, I remember I visited the Kickstarter page a little while ago. I can't remember. I wish I remembered the name of the company so I can verify what I'm saying, if it's true or not.
I wish so too.
But no, I did visit it a while ago, and there was people like commenting like, okay, so you're going to give us some news on what's going on? And it's been empty for weeks.
Yeah, that's the problem. It's not getting it. It's not getting news about how it's progressing, because they could be sitting at home working diligently to do it, but you don't know.
Mm-hmm. Well, damn, they got $210,000.
Yeah.
Yeah. They need to get some messages out there saying, we're doing it. It's in progress. This is where we are at.
I'm not trying.
Two player production is the group.
Oh.
Stuff takes time to make. And
oh, yeah. These guys are still active. I'm positive of it because I read recently that they went back to Sweden or something. Hold on.
I'm looking it up. Guys, fill the dead air. Fill it.
I'm looking too.
So bad. How about us being a yin and yang?
Their last blog.
Okay, there we go.
Their last blog post was March 1st,
2012. Spoons.
Yeah, it's months, man.
Yeah, they went to the Double Fine to go check out, because they're working on Psychonauts 2. So yeah, I don't know what's happened.
See, if you go to the comments, that's what it's filled with, like people asking what's going on. See, look, right there. It would be nice to have an update.
Where do you see comments at?
Click where it says comments at the top.
No.
Oh, I was on their website. I'm sorry.
Oh, no. Go to Kickstarter. Here, I'll link it for you.
I found it here.
Well, someone said that there's an update. Just ask 2PP over Twitter what's up. Got this. Mojang will be viewing the cut later this month, and we should be on track for a December release. That was posted on September 6th.
Right, but you think they'd post something on their Kickstarter. Like, look at all those comments, man.
Yeah, they really should have been more active in the Kickstarter. I'll agree there. But it looks like they have been working on it, at least.
I hope so. I'd really like to see it. That trailer was awesome.
Yeah.
I'll make sure that this tweet is actually in the...
In the description?
Yep.
Great job, man. Great job.
This guy, he's come around.
Nice guy pause. So we had a group event recently, a couple of them. The first one was the Wither. We took on, we're amazing, I gotta be honest.
I'm not, I died both accounts.
We got all these people dying to withers. Oh, the wither is just too hard. And we took on three of them, and there were only like 20 of us.
Whoa, but you gotta word it properly. We took on one, we destroyed the first one, then we took two on at a time.
Yeah.
I wanna summon like six or 10 or something. Just a whole shitload of them.
We gotta figure out the wither to player ratio.
Right.
We gotta do studies for science.
It's gotta be a formula.
Yeah. 1-to-1.
Oh, 1-to-1.
Wow, really? 1-to-1?
I was thinking 2-to-1, but yeah.
Yeah, but as soon as you get withered, you're pretty much bone unless you have like the health pots. I didn't anticipate that.
Yeah, I had nothing on me. Like I had some good armor and some good weapons, and apparently we were having a fight afterwards I didn't know about, and I lost all my stuff.
I think from everyone this point on,
I think when we have a group event like that, everyone needs to come dressed like Etho, because he comes off at the end like goddamn Arnold Schwarzenegger or something.
Yeah, no, Etho's the king of PvP.
I mean, he had ender pearls, a full inventory of potions.
He had a bow with like knockback 5 million on it. I've never been hit so hard with an arrow.
Oh man, explosive tips.
That may have been me. That might have been Paul's Bane.
Paul's Bane. Yeah. when I was doing my trolling of invincibility, Badge actually shot me with that bow and one hit me for all 10 hearts. It was ridiculous.
Oh, I saw that. That was crazy.
I wasn't anticipating that.
What's that bow have on it?
Power 4, kick 2, I think.
Punch 2?
Yeah, that's the one.
Doesn't kick, it punches.
Hey, my bow's kick.
Different limbs, man.
I don't know. That almost kicked me in real life.
Just like your head snaps back.
Yeah, like, Jesus!
And the second event we did, the B-Team Trial. Dun-dun-dun. Where I guess we could talk about the first half of it. Well, yeah, we could talk about the first half of it, guys. Be careful what you say here.
Yeah, can't talk about the
I love the fact that Paz totally betrayed you.
No one knew about that. No one knew about that. I loved it.
Yeah.
Well, I found out about it like seconds before the trial. Etho told me.
Yep. But
I felt so unprepared, though. That's the only thing I hate. Like, the thing that really sucked is that I had some notes. They were in a Google Doc, and we changed all the passwords this last weekend on all our shit, and my wife wasn't here, so I didn't know where the fuck the password book was, and so I was trying to get to my Google Doc, like after the wither, and just could not find my password, so I couldn't get to my Google Doc, so the notes I did have, I didn't get to use.
Well, about a half hour before... me and Etho, I guess we had a little client a client conference. I don't know what you call it. I'm not a legal professional, but we talked out. We sat down and talked for about 30 minutes about what really happened. And I actually wrote down stuff. This is the dumbest thing I've ever done. Like for a Minecraft skit, I'm like taking down notes and preparing like it was homework or something.
Well, like right before we even started, like 5 minutes in, I went to go find those two videos that I said I was going to use as video evidence. And then I just made those tiny URLs up just like right on the spot, just like you have them.
It was fun, though. First half. Stay tuned to see if the second half was just as fun.
Yeah. Dude, the timing on that lightning and stuff, you couldn't beat it.
That was perfect. Yeah, I don't really want to say too much more. Badge, you have anything to add?
No, I mean, I could have done with a bit more prep time as well, to be honest with you.
Yeah, you were the judge, man. You were in the toughest spot.
Yeah, it was about 2 o'clock in the morning, so I couldn't really
shout. And you were eating a cheese sandwich.
Yep, that cheese sandwich.
The water at the start was some of the best shit I've ever heard. It just... It's like you spilled it all over your face or something. Like you needed to wake up. It was too late or something. You just... poured it all over you.
It's annoying because I didn't record any of that because I was eating.
Your cheese sandwich.
Oh, man. And
my crisps.
Should we mention that we plan on doing group things regularly on Fridays?
Yeah. Yeah. I really like that.
I think...
No, we should mention that. Okay.
Okay, let's not.
Do we have anything? Don't say if we do, but I don't think we have anything planned this Friday, do we?
We do.
We do.
We do.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll tell you what it is later.
All right, cool. Suckers. So the compact disc is just about as old as I am. 30 years old, it turned. Yeah, I thought
you're older than it.
I'm 30. I just turned 31. Yeah, so I am a little older than the CD. Good's older than I am, and Badge is older than all of us. So, just thought I'd throw that in there.
Badge was around when they first made vinyls.
Oh,
you know, I didn't realize that the CD was developed in 1982. It certainly sat around for a while before it came out, didn't it?
No kidding. 76.
What's that?
76. Philips created it.
Oh, it says in.
So CNN's got it wrong?
Wouldn't be the first time.
Oh, no, the first commercial compact disc was released in October 1st, 1982. It was Billy Joel's 52nd Street. So I guess maybe it was developed prior than that, but
the
first
sat around for 4 years.
Yeah.
But it's a little obsolete now, isn't it?
Yeah.
No, I just bought a new CD.
Yeah, but
really? You still buy CDs?
Yeah, I got the Mumford & Sons CD.
Oh, God.
Oh, shut up, Bash.
But I mean, like, you look all over the place, HMVs are starting to close down and start, they're trying to, like, have a new HMVs.
Do you know what the hell's that?
It's where we buy music in Canada.
Yeah. Oh.
HMV in the States.
Yeah. There's no HMVs?
There might be up north near the Canadians.
Oh, yeah. But last week you said we didn't have kite shops and everybody posted that. Duh.
Yeah.
Well, okay. Yes, of course, at the fucking beach where you people fly kites. Yes,
yeah, where you live is just rocking horse chairs and banjo shops, isn't it?
Right, exactly. There are no kite shops. Let me go to Google right now and try to find a fucking kite shop. I'll have to drive 4 hours at least to get to a kite shop.
Are rocking horse chairs for horses?
No, shops. I
thought they were just rocking chairs, but if they're rocking horse chairs,
no, they're really.
That's what he said.
But yeah, like right now, I think it's definitely dying, man. Just let it go, Good. Don't buy CDs. Just download your stuff, man.
Well, you know what's sad is the damn CD drive.
Legally,
legally, of course, iTunes. I mean, I'm talking about.
Well, yeah, I bought the CD twice because the CD drive on my computer doesn't work, so I fucking downloaded it.
Nice.
Oh, so you bought the CD and it doesn't.
It's got DRM on it.
And what?
Like, anybody's going to copy that?
I don't think so, because I put it in my laptop and I was able to copy it on my laptop, but then it was in a shitty format that my car wouldn't play, so I still needed like an MP3 format, so I just bought it again.
So when did CDs become more prevalent? Because I mean, I remember like when I was young, the very first like musical thing I bought was a disc, and it was a Mortal CD? Kombat.
Was it made by Fisher Price and go
no,
in the
no,
back
no.
of the
it was
train.
A Mortal Kombat disc
like
disc.
The
it wasn't a CD. I don't remember CDs
like for your PlayStation.
No, for my cassette player.
What,
cassette?
Yeah,
wait,
so it was a cassette.
It was not a CD then?
No, I'm asking, when did CDs become like more popular? Because I remember like when I was a kid, I was buying cassettes.
Oh okay.
Oh yeah, I was buying cassettes until my teens.
Mm-hmm. I mean, like 30 is seems like it's so long ago, but then CDs like seem like they're only around for a couple of years, and then now it's just starting to get taken over by software.
Yeah, but the first stuff was really expensive.
Yeah,
so you've got to wait 5 to 10 years for the technology to trickle down.
And I wonder if the CDs that were released in 1982, were they the same size as CDs now? Or are we talking about these big ass CDs?
No, those are laser discs.
Okay,
yeah,
those different things.
Do you guys had films on.
Do you guys remember what your first CD was that you ever bought?
I think.
I do.
What was it?
So it was Warren G, Regulate. None of you guys know what that is. Well, Badge does. I know Badge does.
Yeah. That's the right tune, actually.
I liked it. I liked the, but I don't know. It's funny to me.
It was something country. That's all I can remember.
There's one of those MTV Texas musical hits.
NASCAR themes.
MTV musical things, boss?
No, it's like
the compilation CDs they do?
Yeah, what were those called?
Hits Volume 3. Music.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, exactly. It's like Dance Volume 4.
No, but it had like...
That, now what it's music's up to like 96 or something now.
Yeah, it's... Mm-hmm.
You guys remember what your first set was?
I said Mortal Kombat.
Okay. Either of you guys?
For the first cassette?
Yeah. I remember it too because it was also very ridiculous.
No. I remember buying.
I remember my first single, vinyl.
Some band that sang Lean on Me, but I still think that was my first.
My first one was Public Enemy.
Oh my God. You're so gangster, Beef.
I'm very gangster. I am extremely gangster, sir.
Yeah, you sound so gangster.
I'm quite gangster.
I'll use my credit card to buy this lovely gangster CD disc.
CD disc?
Oh, good afternoon, sir. Do you have Public Enemy?
Pardon me. Looking for Public Enemy. But it was, yeah, it was good times. I used to record a whole bunch from the radio, though.
Yeah, that's all I remember doing. That was my first cassette, was, you know, some radio ripoff.
You hope the guy wouldn't talk at the beginning? Man, dude, please don't
talk. Yeah. I'm trying to get this right.
These kids have no idea what we're talking about right now.
Nope.
Yeah, I remember going around to a friend's house and being everybody saying, shh, be quiet. Tape recorder's upstairs recording the radio.
Oh, man, okay, we should move on before we really get ourselves.
We're not older than we already are.
Yeah, exactly.
When I was young, this is all grass.
We don't have the proper demographic to talk about this stuff, I don't think.
So DayZ, the standalone. The DayZ standalone's coming out in December.
Targeted for
you
December.
Excited? Oh, pause.
I'm so excited.
That seems so quick to me.
Really?
Is that not quick?
I mean, it seems quick. It's been in alpha for the first game you bought?
What?
First game? Let's date ourselves some more. The first game.
Math Blaster.
It was for I can't remember what it was. I can't remember the name of it. It was like a car with a gun on the top, and it was like.
Was it Interstate 76?
No, God no! This was CGA, man. This was four colors.
I love that game, bastard guy. Yeah, my first game was probably an Atari game of some. I think it was Rampage actually for the 2600.
So we had an Intellivision, and we had all the games for it.
God, you had a ColecoVision.
Well, maybe that's what I'm thinking about. Was the thing? Is the ColecoVision with the little disc, the little silver disc thing, and you had
it had a cartridge and then two like telephone pads with a big knob on it.
I'm talking about the controller, like a little silver.
Yeah, it's a silver mushroom on the top, and
it was like wood paneled the device. No, itself.
Big number pad, like it was made for your granny or someone who was blind.
Oh, if it's got wood paneling, it's
I think
good granny material.
2600 had wood paneling, didn't it?
How do you spell Coleco?
No, not mine. Mine was, I guess,
the Coleco, I think.
Coleco. There we go. I'm trying to remember if it was the Coleco or the Intellivision that we had.
My dad, being tight, bought it in a shop that specialized in selling out of date stock. So
don't worry, kids.
I don't buy any more games for it.
No, my 2600 was the more sleek model. The one was just all black. It had no wood paneling, sort of like a wedge shape. It was like a doorstop shape.
Oh, yeah, it was definitely the Intellivision that I'm thinking of. And, yeah, it has wood paneling here. I'll send you a link.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so, yeah, back on topic. DayZ. Now, I don't know. Like, none of us really play DayZ, so pause if you want to say something about it. Pause? Okay. You muted your mic.
No, I'm still here. I just was really awkward because I can't talk about old school consoles like you old folks.
Sure you can. You're just a little younger school. I mean, you're not that much younger than us. Get over yourself.
I don't know. I'm pretty excited because with the standalone, I'm hoping that the maps will actually have more homes and places that you can actually go into rather than just like trying to search every window to see which one is frosted and which one is see-through and all this. I don't know. I'm just excited because, you know, new stuff. The game's awesome. So,
when's the WarZ going to come out?
I don't know, but
are they going to be like competing with each other at the same time of year?
Well, actually, I think he, like in this article, he said that he's not really worried about clones, but that's actually one of the reasons why he's trying to push it out to bring it out sooner.
He's not worried, but he wants to market.
No, he's not like worried that like WarZ or anything is like going to kill him or anything like that, but he just wants to get it out before a clone brings it out, you know?
Mm-hmm. Like WarZ. Well, he is the originator.
Yeah. And the good thing I'm happy about is he also said that he's gonna sell it at like a low price so people can play it and not, you know, spend like $60 for just multiplayer stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So
interesting.
I'm excited. Except I don't good. Know.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. So good and pause. You guys have iPhones, right?
Yep.
Uh huh.
Did you guys Did you guys hear that Apple Maps suck cook?
Suck cook. That's what it says.
Tim Cook apologized for Apple Maps.
Did that?
Oh, yeah, I was reading an article today that the iPhone 5 apparently has got a bug if you're with Verizon, and everyone's using, like, 2 gigs of data a day.
Oh, my God. Jesus, are you serious?
Yeah.
That's my monthly limit right there.
Right, yeah, people have gone, like, gigs over their monthly limit if they're with Verizon. So Apple put out a patch for it, but, yeah. I haven't messed with the new maps because, my phone's still using the iOS 4. I haven't updated to 5 or 6. Oh, but I updated my iPad, and I looked at it, and it doesn't look as good as Google Maps. That's all I'll say.
That was one of their big selling features, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, you know, Google released a statement about it, too, and they were really dickish about it. Like, it was hilarious. They were like, well, we didn't really tell Apple to get rid of it, but those of you that are asking if we're going to make an app that you can download, no. It's Apple's problem now.
Good for them.
So
apparently they took on some people to actually program it days before the release.
God.
Days before the release.
Wow. Also, slightly related, I did find out the other day that an iPhone 5 cost $250 roughly to make.
Wow. So they're doubling their money.
Tripling their money.
Triple, yeah.
Oh, is it that expensive?
Yeah.
Wow, what a waste.
It's like an extra
That's before cost and stuff. But.
Right.
And I say what a waste, not because it's not a good piece of technology, because you'll never use 95% of the things that are input into your phone.
Right.
Well, I just paid for my phone. Like, you know, I got the iPhone, not the 4G, just the one before that.
The 3GS?
No, that's just the 4. Okay, I got the 4G, not the 4GS. Okay.
Ah, okay. Gotcha.
Sorry. It was just free with a 1-year contract with AT&T.
It's not bad.
Yeah. So I guess you didn't really pay for it, but you're still paying for it.
Well, yeah. I mean, I'd have to have phone service either way, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I could have bought a 4GS and paid them like $400 or something like that with the year contract, or I could get a free 4G, you know? So it's like, why would you? I don't need Siri.
It's bloody impossible to get a 1-year contract on a decent phone these days around here.
Really?
Yeah, it's all 2-year.
Huh.
It's 2 years. Which annoys the hell out of me because 2 years is such a long time for a phone.
Oh, yeah, someone our age, too. Could be dead in that time.
So I'm reading in the article that Apple is, quote-unquote, extremely sorry. But, I mean, like I said, 2 gigs is my limit. And, you know, a lot of these telephone companies, they offer certain, you know, what is the word? Caps and everything. Limited? No. Yeah, limited. Like data, monthly data limit. So are they going to be paying for the money?
No, because, hell no.
No, Verizon already said that they're not going to charge for the bug. Here's the thing I don't understand. You know, whenever the smartphones came about, the first thing all these providers did was up it to unlimited access. And it seems like now that people are using more internet, they've started putting caps on it. Like, how the fuck does that make any sense at all? It feels like it's AOL all over again.
Yeah. Well, it's the same with broadband, though. They make your speed faster and faster and faster, and then they bring the caps down and down and down.
Right.
So, yeah, you can download at 50, 100 megasecond, but in 15 minutes, you're going to use up your cap for the month.
We're running out of internets, guys.
There are no more internets to go around.
The tubes are full.
Well, that's good that I'm happy that Verizon is not being a dick and making them pay for that.
Yeah, that'd probably result in some kind of class action.
Have any of you guys ever been over your limit?
Oh, yeah.
I
Good-ass.
Went over like a couple megabytes. Yeah,
server.
And it was like a $200 extra limit.
Jeez.
$200 extra on my account, which was...
Yeah, that's the thing, man. They really rape you with the. It's like you get 2 gigs or whatever with your monthly service that you're paying like $50 or $60 for, but then you go over by like 5 megs, and it's like, here you go, it's a $500 bill.
Mm-hmm.
It's just crazy. It's
ridiculous.
You know what else is ridiculous?
Questions?
Oh no! All these people talking about UHC all the time. When are you gonna do UHC? You gotta do UHC. So here you go. We're gonna talk about the UHC. We're gonna talk about the Minecraft. The Minecraft fan server UHC, suckas! So it's underway, and if you guys have a hankering for some UHC, go and watch it. There's lots of great people on the Minecraft fan server. Just because the word fan is in there doesn't mean that they suck. So go and watch that UHC. Give it a chance. Go Jason27.
it's funny, you know, since I've started doing these tours weekly, all these people comment about, oh, wow, these people are great. I never knew about them and all this. And it's like, they've always been there.
Yeah.
Like, I think people discriminate because the word fan is in the server. And
so most people can't see past Etho anyway, so it's...
Well, what if they changed their name? They should just change their name.
Well, that was recommended at one point, but they said they didn't want to.
Really? See, they're nice people.
Yeah, they're all they're fans of life. They're not fans of Minecraft.
Sure it is. The Life fan server. So yeah, that's going on. If you guys want to watch some UHC action, go ahead and watch their stuff. Ours is we're thinking about it. Don't worry about it. It'll be out when it's out.
Yeah, we're worried about fall damage more than anything.
Yeah, we're worried about the bugs right now. Like, I mean, we can revert back to 1.2.5, but then I could see, like, an outlash of people being like, oh, but now you can't set up certain traps.
that's the best impression ever.
That's great. I have a few suggested changes for it, but we'll discuss that at a later date.
Yeah. Oh, yeah?
Okay. Wow.
I mean, I'm intrigued.
Guys, oh, yeah. Stay tuned for Bash in a couple weeks.
All right, I think maybe let's answer some questions from the peoples.
Talking of Badge, it's time for him to talk. Hi, guys. My name's Ali, and recently I feel I had one of the biggest fails of my life. So my question is as follows. What is the biggest fail that has ever happened to you? Doesn't need to be life-changing, just a fail that you'll remember for the rest of your life.
Wow, Ali, way to not tell us your fail while we have to tell ours.
No kidding. I was waiting for
at way some to be point. Selfish.
Damn, Ali.
Do you guys have anything?
Ollie.
I got caught having sex once by my mom.
By your who?
Is that a fail, though?
Oh,
that's a win.
No, I don't think so.
He got caught by his mom. That's not a win.
No.
He's having sex.
I mean, she didn't walk in on me like she knocked on the door. I'd locked the door, and she knocked on the door.
Was there someone else with you?
Yeah, I wasn't. I think I got caught masturbating.
Okay.
But I had little outside access to my room, oh, hey. House.
Oh, a little outside access, huh? Rear entrance.
So she ran out there on the porch, and then my mom came in, and she was like, why are y'all sweaty? And I was like, it's hot in here. I was packing because I was about to leave to visit my grandma. And and so she was like, my mom was not dumb. So she started looking around, looked on the porch. And the worst part was she called the girl by my ex-girlfriend's name, so it really didn't help the matter at all.
But she did that on purpose.
I don't know. But she was naked, too. And she was like, get in here. Get your clothes off. I'm taking you home. And I was like, because, I was 17 and she was 15. And I was like, she's not the right age. So, anyways, this story's gone on way too long.
Get a little further than it should have.
Yep.
FBI are coming.
I had a pretty bad fail when I worked at a grocery store. It was... There was a guy that came in wearing a construction vest, you know, those glow-in-the-dark vests?
Yeah.
You guys know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Okay, and he had a construction hat on. He was all decked out in construction gear. And I was working in the back room, and he pokes his head in and asks, I'm here to fix something. I forgot what he said it was. So how do you get upstairs? I'm like, oh, you just go up the stairs that way and just climb the stairs on your left there, and you're right up there. So he leaves, and a little while later, the store manager comes down and asks me if I told some guy how to get upstairs. I'm like, yeah, he said he was here to repair whatever it was. Turns out, the guy robbed us.
Wow!
he went into the cash, because we have a cash room, I guess is what we called it, where it's like, there's a person always inside, and the door's locked, and that's where we keep all our cash, like from the day before. I guess until they deliver it or something. But the guy knocks on the door, and the person inside the cash room, he opened the door a touch because he didn't recognize the guy's face. So he just opened it up slightly. The dude with the construction hat pulls out an axe.
What? An axe?
And threatens the guy with his life if he doesn't open the door and let him in. The other guy punched him in the nose. The guy was in the room, punched the would-be thief in the nose. And then the guy just ran away. So he didn't officially take anything, but he tried to rob us, and it was a little bit because of me.
Awesome.
Just a little bit.
That was an awesome story.
I had no idea.
I wish I'd gone first now.
Oh, are you not as good? You not? Go ahead.
I do remember my first day of my first job after I got out of college, you know, first real proper job. I managed to wipe the hard drive on the computer, which had like 3 years worth of work on it.
Pretty good.
That's a great I was quite popular after that.
I bet. Hey, white bee.
Hey, all this great stuff you've done, I've just deleted it.
Nice.
I guess for me recently, it was right around the summer. I got so excited because we have a pool on top of our roof on our apartment, and I got early access because my girlfriend works here. So I went upstairs.
Mr. Flash.
Yep. And I was so excited that I put my phone in my pocket because I like to listen to music whenever I'm swimming sometimes. And I jumped in, and about an hour of swimming afterwards, I get out. I realized that I left my phone in there. So I went out. I bought a new phone. A month later, I washed my new phone. So
that is pretty good, man.
It's terrible.
You go through phones like a champ.
I know. It's ridiculous.
So when you get in the iPhone 5.
I'm not.
Next week after he drops his current one in the toilet.
Yeah. No, I still got I bought extended warranty, so it allows you like two exchanges if something happens. I already went through one, so basically if I go through this one, I get one more. If I break the next one, then I have to buy a new one.
Extended warranties apply to like user negligence?
Yeah, that's she was talking and she's like, you know, you can get warranty for like water damage in that, and yeah, so.
Oh, okay, that's cool. That's good to know.
Yeah.
Your phone's getting a little old.
Go wash it.
Lots of fail.
Don't do
there,
it
guys.
Unless you don't have that.
Definitely make sure you have the waterproof warranty.
It's watertight. So, Meg says, "Hello, guys. What do you think that's Meg from Family Guy? I first wanted to say that I really enjoy your channels and videos, even Badge. They make my day seem so much better. I have two questions. One, what do you think of female Let's Players? And two, what's your opinion on fan art?" God, I nearly read that wrong. thank you, guys. Keep doing everything great. Thank you.
What do you think of female Let's Players? Well, they normally have vaginas.
I think they're pretty.
And my opinion of fan art is it's cool.
It's awesome. I've started saving all the fan art into a folder now because my cousin actually was telling me, he asked me, "Do you save all the fan art?" And I'm like, no, it's the internet. It'll be there forever. Then I realized that I will never find it.
No. Yeah.
So I've started saving everything.
I don't get much fan art.
woe is me.
I was just joking with the answer to question one, though.
Oh, yeah, clear that up. Go ahead. Keep going.
No, don't call me sexist. No, that's really all. I mean, I think let's play. I mean, they're just people. It's people.
Yeah.
It's like, what's your opinion of women and men? It's all people, man.
You don't have to separate it into gender.
Right.
No, there are two sorts of female Let's Players, though, aren't there? There's those that play the game like everybody else, and there's those that giggle and sit there and have lots of cleavage and don't actually seem to know what they're doing.
Oh, and they have like the face cam going on, and and there's like it should be called tit cam or something.
Yeah, it's all look at me. I'm geeky.
Well, I think those people are just pandering to the nerdy guys that are out there, you know. And
yeah.
I don't really agree with that.
Sorry, ladies, I love nerds. Doing you lot any favors.
I love nerds. Zelda in his green hat. Oh, so cute.
Zelda in his green hat. Oh, that was good.
So yeah, girl Let's Players, cool. Fan art, cool. Next question.
It's very enthusiastic about that.
Fan art, cool. So Zach says, "So I've been hugely into Bilby's Retro Gaming Month streams, even though he only ever streams from 5 a.m. onwards, Australian time." Rude word. "And I was wondering if any of you guys are interested in the whole stream shenanigans going on these days, as I think whilst you seem to get a lot of idiots in your community on YouTube, you seem to get more level-headed and constructive fans following you on streams. And it can be interesting seeing you guys interact with that part of the community, you know, since most of them are smarter than the average mountain goat. I also seem to find it absolutely necessary to tell you my biology teacher is hot as two."
Hot as two?
It's hot as two.
Huh. It's hot as two.
It's hot as. Like, yeah.
It's a good thing it's not his English teacher.
She would be thoroughly unimpressed.
Have a nice day. Huh. G'day, right. Bruce.
Well, you know, from someone that's watched Paul's streams and seen the person that Paul's becomes in his streams.
I don't know what you're saying, man. I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Either the fans are not the nice mountain goats that you speak of, or Paul's just an asshole?
The nice mountain goats.
Well, the thing is, there's moderation going on constantly on the chat, isn't there? So right. There are dicks out there, but it gets cut off. Whereas we've got a time delay on YouTube, so when we do cut them off, it's a while later.
And also,
I think there's. Go ahead, pause.
When you get more people, and I'm not trying to sound like negative towards Milby, you know, I watch his live streams. Go check him out, guys. He needs more people there. But you know, with when you have more people come in, you're gonna just get more dickish people trying to troll you.
It's the asshole quoting, man.
Yeah, I mean, for like the longest time, I had a person who, whenever I went live, yes, I live streamed too, not just Milby. Whenever I went live, I got DDoSed, so I had to actually stop for like a month or two there. Because whenever I went live, I just instantly down.
I used to quite enjoy doing those little Minecraft things with you on the live stream.
Yeah, no.
Let's
do it. Let's do a bash.
Oh, love has bloomed.
City maps.
I just want to say that, they're I'm pretty sure they're mostly the same exact people. There's dummies on YouTube and there's dummies on live streams. You get the same type of people, man.
Some people just want attention.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you also get the people who like say, do you miss when your channel was smaller because you didn't have many dickish people around? It's the same thing with streaming, you know. The more people, you're going to get some vocal people in there, so.
So there, guy.
Yeah. There.
You tell your biology teacher she's hot as two.
Yeah, any pictures on that. We used to have quite a hot teacher, and she always wore very loose, flowing tops. And if she'd take the register, she'd bend over the desk to do it. And
very nice.
There'd be a big crowd of boys in front of her.
My math teacher, when I was in sixth grade in Texas, everyone just thought she was so fucking hot. Well, the next year she gets fired because she'd been sleeping with half the football team. We're all sixth graders.
That is awesome.
The worst part is I was on the football team, man.
Sixth graders, how is that awesome beef? What the fuck?
Nice.
obviously, a little bit of sarcasm there. But I like the part where Good mentioned he was on the football team.
Yeah, and I did not get to sleep with her, man. And I had this one friend, Billy, that did. And I was like, what the fuck, man? You didn't tell me? We were always talking about how hot she is and all this, and then you're the one sleeping with her? Just, there's a
Bash,
story.
Was that a South Park reference? Nice.
It might have been.
Well done, Badger.
Nice. So, David says, I saw something similar to this on Ask Reddit a while ago, but I thought it'd be fun for you guys to talk about it on the podcast. What's something you do differently than most people?
That's a good example.
X Seamy's example.
Yeah.
It should be EG. Wiping standing up. P.S. Good, you were right about my question. I'll be glad to start English lessons with you. Well, that's private gag, apparently.
I guess so.
No, a couple podcasts ago, I think the same guy submitted a question and you guys answered it wrong, and I was trying to tell you guys what he meant, and you were all like, no, you're an idiot.
Okay. Something that we do differently than most people.
Don't know, really.
Trying to think here.
You have to know how most people do things, really, don't you?
You put your pants on one nub at a time?
I hold them out and jump into them both legs.
I wish I was like Costanza, took my shirt off when I went to the bathroom. That'd be an awesome story to tell people. But no,
I think the thing is with something like this, you don't realize you do it any differently just because that's just the way you do it.
And that might be the case. I'm trying to think. I really can't think of anything. I'm sure there's tons of stuff.
I guess for me, I don't think it's that weird. But I mean, like for me, I love cereal. So whenever I get a cereal, I just put it in like a huge big bowl and just eat it.
A big bowl. That's what you do different.
Yeah. I don't have milk with a lot of cereals.
That's kind of weird.
Yeah. There you go.
I tend to pick the ones that there's a really nice one called Crave, which is like got chocolate Nutella stuff in the middle, and that's really nice to eat.
That sounds good. Those stuff are amazing.
Just shovel those in.
So
good. They're nice. They're snacky snacks. You know,
Is it like gooey Nutella or is it like dried?
Yeah, it's gooey.
Oh man, we don't have gooey cereal.
They're little pillows of crispy cereal shells with a milk chocolate center.
Oh man, that sounds like you
sold it.
I want some of that.
Dude, I know what you do.
I don't have breakfast, so.
Oh man.
Oh, that might be something different. Well, I think a lot of people don't.
I don't have breakfast.
Yeah, I don't eat breakfast either.
Okay, so we're all the same.
I know what Good does differently. He cannot have his hands dirty whenever he eats food.
You were going to say that.
Whenever he what?
Whenever he eats food, he cannot have his hands the slightest bit dirty. He won't lick his fingers. He'll just wipe it on a napkin. And if the napkin's the slightest bit dirty, he'll grab a new one.
We had barbecue in Birmingham.
It doesn't matter.
Dude, barbecue is so dirty. I had to go through
like your mouth.
Barbecue, you're supposed to be like licking your fingers, licking that sauce. Yes.
You can't wipe stuff off your hand that's going in your mouth.
Yeah, you can. I do it all the time.
You've got grease on your hands. You can wipe that off. That's fair enough. Engine grease. You've got barbecue sauce on your hand and you're shoveling chicken in your gob and then lick your fingers.
No.
Why put the trousers?
Like anytime we eat crab or something like that, where it's like real juicy. Like,
well, that's what you're doing wrong for a start.
Same way. What? What? You don't like crab?
Minging stuff.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Okay. That's a good point there, Paul.
So,
moving on.
Next question.
Dustin says, do you guys think Minecraft will ever get to a point where there are too many features?
No. Well, maybe.
I don't think for us, but I think definitely for new people.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, didn't Terraria have a problem with that when it started going, oh, there's too many things going on?
I think that's one of the things that ruined the game, even for me, because I thought about going back and playing it some more to see all the new stuff, but it's overwhelming, the amount of stuff there. I don't want to have to read a wiki, you know, that takes 10 hours to read just to play the game.
You know, where we come from, we've been playing it from the beginning, so, you know, we're always looking for new changes.
Every new feature is a small amount for us. But yeah, if new people are just picking up the game now, and this new snapshot even, like, look at all this stuff.
Yeah. All right.
If Mojang are listening to this, ignore them. We want lots more new features.
Oh, that's the whole start of the podcast.
We're not disagreeing with this.
Yeah.
You know, we're just stating that for some people, it could be seen as overwhelming.
I think that eventually there'll be the mod API, and I think you'll be able to pick. I think even Mojang editions will be part of some kind of checklist when you start up the game, where you can pick what, you know, how you want to play the game. You know, do you want to have the end? Do you want to have the Nether, stuff like that? I think, that seems like an idea that could work.
Nice. So, Ryan says, on the TV Tropes page for the server, it says that Good gathered the greatest minds of Minecraft Let's Play. How do you guys feel about that? And if you don't see the server as a collection of the greatest minds, who would you say are the greatest minds of Minecraft LPs?
Etho.
Kurt.
Get out of the way.
So I don't get disliked, Etho.
It's weird that it says that I gathered the greatest
minds.
Because, I mean, like, you know, like people like Beef and Paws and Badge. Well, Paws, you know, was already a Let's Player, but Beef had just started, and Badge didn't even have a channel. Did you, Badge?
Nope. I started just for your compa.
So, like, I don't think that I didn't go out looking for the greatest Let's Players. We just, there was contests and great people joined. And,
well, people still don't think I'm the greatest.
Even Badge.
Who would you say are the greatest Minecraft Let's Players?
I don't do that.
I don't know if he's the greatest. I don't know if he's the greatest, but honestly, Etho's a pretty bright guy. Let's be honest. Lesbianus?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, but we all love Etho as much as a man can love another man, don't we?
Yeah.
I mean, I love everyone on the server. Makes sweet love to Packrat, I guess. Just kidding! Before anyone, I didn't call him anything or anything. Just
you should put it in context. You thought earlier today.
Oh, yeah. Like, his trial video was 55 minutes, and people on Reddit said he'd upload the whole thing, so I just, like, attacked the guy. I
freaked out.
Why can't you not listen?
But the truth is, he doesn't hate Packrat. Calm down.
Yeah, I don't hate Packrat. And people keep posting, why was Shree not invited? Why was the Gems not invited? I want to fucking say it for the 1800th time. Everyone is invited to group events. If they don't show up, they couldn't make it.
We have a giant Skype group called Minecraft. Everyone in the Minecraft server is in there. We told people that we're doing it this Friday. The people who didn't show up, that was their own choice. Don't tell us that we didn't invite people. Sincerely, the rest of the Minecraft crew.
I responded to some guy saying it was past Shree's bedtime. He's like, that's fucking rude to just climb a little kid with a bedtime. Well, you know what? It was past his fucking bedtime.
He is a kid.
It was past his bedtime, too.
Jesus. Gonna have an aneurysm.
Well, I mean, that is a problem because we do a lot of things that are convenient time for over there.
Uh-huh.
And for us over here, it's a bit tricky. But
we outnumber. Yeah.
Start your own Minecraft, you jerk.
Probably will do.
Yeah.
That'd be better. They don't have blackjacks and hookers.
Ooh,
oh, man.
I'm going to join there.
In fact, screw the blackjack.
He's going to have a new map, Beef.
Oh, man, I'm in. Yes!
I'll join you, Beef.
Oh, but there went Minecraft.
There goes all your greatest minds.
Yeah, I think it's wrong to pick favorites anyways.
I like Etho. Let's just choose a few questions from this one. There's
a lot of questions in this next one, isn't there?
I took out a couple because there's like one that asked, what's your favorite console? I don't want a console war. In the
Blue.
Comments.
Oh.
Winfield says, do you feel pressured to post at least one video per day?
Yes.
No.
I do.
Yeah, I think those of us that rely on this as our job do.
Yes.
I was
honestly everyone I've ever known that's done YouTube, if they take like a week off, they've lost half their fucking subscribers.
Oh. Yeah.
The funny thing was, when I went out to BC, some guy posted, because I was just posting one video a day, he was like, wow, Paz, you've really got lazy. Ever since you hit a 100,000 subscribers, you've just been posting one video every 24 hours. I was like, and this guy claimed that he watches every single one of my videos, and I post a video saying, I'm going away for a week. Just one video a day.
The people that say they watch all of your videos very rarely are the ones.
Yeah. Or, you know, are the biggest fan.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean,
how do you even gauge that?
I don't know.
The size
the week,
of
the week I was on holiday, my AdSense just dropped to pocket money. Not this particularly large anyway. What was your first console? Well, I think we've gone through this one already, haven't
we? Atari 2600.
And television.
SNES. What was the first game? What was the first game you ever played or bought?
Oh, first game. Wait, weren't we just talking about this too?
Yeah.
We can just move on.
Rampage.
Forest Go Skiing.
I don't remember.
Goldeneye.
Something on television. Or Commodore 64.
Who on YouTube, even outside of Minecraft and gaming, have you met in real life?
Am I good?
No one.
My cousin.
I know.
Yeah. It says outside of Minecraft, doesn't it? Or what,
even that? Outside of Minecraft.
Oh, even outside of Minecraft.
So, like, they can't be a Minecraft player?
No, they can.
Oh, okay.
Even.
I see.
Just anyone on YouTube, I assume.
I see. Well, I met a lot of people on the server, and I met the Marble Hornets guys.
I met my mate that I did the starting Minecraft videos with. Can you do your best American accent badge and British accent for everyone else?
Oh, God. Hello there, Badger. May I clean your chimney?
Do you want to do one right, with my
butthole? Right, cheerio.
Pip, pip.
American accent badge.
I don't want to.
It could be a southern one.
Hell yeah.
That sounds so English.
At least one of us does. Can you guys do your best impression of anyone on the Minecraft server? Please don't all go, hello, guys.
That was my first instinct, was to go with the hello, guys.
Hello, boys and girls.
Hello, boys and girls. This is Andrew Hill, of course.
Bash sounded like Sean Connery.
Yeah. He's on the Minecraft server, right? Didn't he join last week? That's it?
Yeah. I don't have one. Peace out, Girl Scouts.
Guys.
Yeah, I'll do pause.
Beef. Oh, beef. 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 Beef.
So Andrew says, question the first. Do you think that your jobs making YouTube videos have diminished the amount of fun you get from playing video games? I've heard other YouTubers talk rather extensively about how they just can't enjoy video games the same way they did before they started their career. And I was wondering if you felt the same way.
Those people are playing games to get views.
Yeah. You have to play the games you want to play.
Exactly.
Yeah,
I'm loving this. I'm playing way more games than I would normally have time for.
Yeah, but don't you get to the point where you think you're sitting there in the evening, you think, I want to play a game like Game X, but I should really record it, otherwise I'm losing out
money. You get to thinking like you're
a prostitute doing it for free.
Exactly. But
yeah, I agree.
You have to have those games, though.
See, for me, there have been many times where I've played some games by myself. I'm like, damn it, I should have recorded this. This would have been awesome. But, you know, at the end of the day, I don't know. It doesn't really affect me that much, but... There are moments where I do regret not recording certain stuff.
Well, that's not the question, though.
Well, I don't know.
Do you feel like you're not having as much fun now playing video games?
I love games. I've been enjoying games.
Now, I will admit sometimes that halfway through a game, the YouTube community ruins the game for me.
Yeah.
And then I'm not having as much fun as I would have had I played it by myself. Yeah, and you know, I want to bring that up. Paul's just playing the Black Mesa now, and his comments have been exactly what I expected if I had played Half-Life. And everyone's like, no, we got you back, man. We got it. But no, there's too many assholes out there that are Half-Life fanboys, and there's no way you can play that game. And Paul's has proved my point.
I told Beef last night that I have like a couple chapters left. I'm just going to just straight up just beat it before I get too demoralized by the comments.
Mm-hmm.
And then play Mesa. I'm not having...
So good. Nobody got that.
I'm not having the same problem with my Black Mesa. People generally have been quite good. I got a couple of people telling me how I should jump and stuff. And as I say to them, you know, I was playing this game before they were walking. But
see, but you're one of those players who just like to go around and look at art pieces and, you know, see what feelings you get.
You hadn't played Half-Life before.
No, I didn't.
Whereas I had played Half-Life, so I knew that there are trigger points, there are set pieces that, you know, the people say to something else and then it triggers an explosion or whatever. So I knew to stop and wait for that to play out, whereas you didn't. So you went in there and shot things.
Fucking scientists.
Scientists. They're your colleagues, man. They're your friends.
You know what? There's like one guy who made me go in, so I killed him. He's a security guard. I'm just another worker.
I like the comments that contradict each other all the time. Like, you'll see a post from somebody saying, you should do this. Like, for instance, Sleeping Dogs. I keep saying Sleeping Dogs. That's really the only
popular game
I'm playing. I'm sorry. But anyway, there's one person that'll say something like, you should take a cab to each destination to save time. And then directly below is another person saying, you should drive to every destination because driving is more fun. What are you supposed to do in that case?
Yeah.
Just play it like you want to play it. That's
exactly, and that's what
you have to do.
People don't seem to understand that, do they?
No. Then they get mad whenever you do.
Yep.
Yeah. Then it's nice to play a game but not having to talk over it.
Like, that too. Like, Borderlands 1, I got all sad throughout the gameplay, and it really ruined the game for me because of the comments. I mean, people nitpicking to the nth degree, like, oh, that gun was 0.2% better or whatever. And going into Borderlands 2, I remembered all that, but I was like, you know what? The game just came out. I want to play the games. I'm going to enjoy it. But the comments are exactly the same. They're the same. I could copy and paste comments from Borderlands 1 and just put them right onto Borderlands 2, and it's the same fucking shit all over again. And I've just stopped reading them. I don't care. I'm just going to enjoy the game and play it how I want to and fuck everybody.
See, a lot of people complain that YouTubers, they don't talk with their community a lot. It's because I don't want to read through the comments telling me how much I suck at a certain game when I'm having fun. When I read certain comments, it's just like, I don't want to play it anymore.
I can't stop reading them, man. Because, like, it just...
I can't stop.
I'm not going to, and I just keep going back.
To answer the question, I guess the answer is yes.
Sometimes, yeah.
Totally went off in a different tangent there, but whatever.
I think the person originally meant was not taking the comments into account. But if we do take the comments into account, I would say, yeah, I guess it does diminish the fun a little bit.
Yeah, see, like I said, I feel a little guilty sometimes, but that's about it.
I think anything you do as a job changes your attitude towards it. I mean, when I started learning graphics, I mean, I'm trained as a printer, and once I'd learned that, I couldn't look at printed things in the same way because that kind of magic had gone.
Right.
Because you see it in a more technical level. I think you do get that even with games, but yeah. Question the second.
Imagine you're being a porn star. Sorry, now go ahead.
Well, yeah, exactly. You got wonder, haven't you?
Dude, don't. I got an awkward erection now.
your erections are always awkward. You're given control of a small independent country and money isn't the problem. Briefly elaborate on what your primary source of trade would be and how your government system would work. What the fuck?
This is what? Too long.
What's the question?
Yeah, great question. Too long. Question the third. The recent release of Guild Wars 2 has prompted a new discussion about payment plans in MMOs. It isn't a secret that the World of Warcraft payment model is fading away and has been replaced with a free-to-play model. What do you think about the hybrid system that Guild Wars 2 has invented? Personally, I'm a fan of buying something and getting a guaranteed retail experience out of it rather than the free-to-play stuff that usually nickels and dimes you to death. What do you guys think?
What did Guild Wars 2 do different this time? I don't know anything about it.
The Guild Wars just went over my head.
I know Guild Wars 1 was one of the few MMOs I played because you bought the game and then you could play it. I thought the idea of World of Warcraft having to buy the game and then pay to play it seemed like a ridiculous idea to me. So,
well, this is a conversation me and Fallon Paler were having the other night because we played World of Warcraft for like 6 or 7 years. And whenever the expansion just came out, I was like, you know, I've considered buying it and just leveling my character because my levels, my character is 85, so I could just find more levels. Yeah, he's an old guy. Name's Good. On the server Boulderfist. Now it all comes together. Basically, Fowl was like, you know, people that have played this game and paid them for 8 fucking years should maybe get like a free year or something. I think World of Warcraft is losing their people because people don't want to pay $15 a month.
Yeah, and the thing is, if you don't play for 3 weeks because you're on holiday or whatever, that's wasted money, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
I'm done with MMO, so I have no.
I don't know what Guild Wars 2 did, but I agree that you should have to pay it monthly for a game.
I've never played an MMO, so I have nothing to contribute.
I mean, presumably
it's almost, except it's not. Well, no, it's not.
No, it's not even MMO in any way.
I know. I stopped myself. Shut up. Ignore what I just said. Strike it from the record.
Presumably, these fees are to pay for the servers and stuff, aren't they? But most other multiplayer games have got servers running them, so you know, why I don't have to pay monthly to play Battlefield 3.
I mean, there was a time when Blizzard was making like $1 billion a month almost off the monthly fees.
Not surprised.
Or more than that. I don't know. I remember a long time ago looking it up and just being just shocked at how much money they were making. Anyways. Yeah.
Gobsmacked is a good word for that. Sorry.
Final question. Of this guy. What is the future for retail AAA games in this market? Do you believe, like I do, that we're going to see more and more $10 experiences? Do you think we'll see the death of the overpriced, over-budget AAA games anytime soon? Or do you think that we'll see even more AAA titles once the new consoles come out?
Well, I don't know.
Are we kind of seeing that now? I mean,
why the fuck was Borderlands $60? Like, every other game I've ever bought in the last year was like $49.95. Why was Borderlands $59.95?
Because of the console thing. Because every console game is like $59.99.
See, I thought they were $49.99.
No,
dude, if you hype a game up to the point that everybody's really looking forward to it, you can charge what you like.
Mm-hmm. I mean, people wanted to play it, but I really didn't want to pay $60. I have to admit.
I'm pretty sure another EA game. Then
pretty sure the price has to be that because the Xbox version and the PS3 version are also $59.99. So they didn't want to weigh one over the other.
I thought console games were $50, not $60. I didn't realize that. So, okay.
But like I was going to say, I mean, we're kind of seeing that right now. Like, all these EB Games or whatever they're called now, GameStops, are starting to close down because they can't compete with things. And this is just like for Steam because, you know, you can go out and say, I want a new copy of Borderlands and it's going to cost you like $50. But if you go on like Steam, it's going to cost you way less. And I mean, they see Steam as a competitive market right now. So, I don't know.
I said in that example it wasn't less, but yeah.
Yeah, but you know what I mean. Like, I mean, I don't know. I hope that prices will go down. It's ridiculous that we're still paying $60 for, you know, like 4 hours of mediocre single player and then the rest multiplayer.
Yeah, and we've had this discussion before, haven't we, about EA saying they're not going to do single player story-driven games anymore and stuff, and I think that is shallow and wrong. It's just, right. I think in the long term, that's going to backfire. In the short term, yeah, they're going to make more money because they're spending less building the game. But I think in the long term, people are going to go, well, screw you. I'm missing out on an experience. And
yep.
No, kick them in the ass. What do you guys think?
I think I agree with Bash.
I was talking to the people listening.
Oh.
So, Ben says, why do people never listen?
Paul's added that in.
Fair enough. If you were
Good. Right? We've done this question many times.
Have we?
If you all were never to become YouTube famous, I think he's talking about you three, what would you work towards being? College? A dream job? Good, I knew you ran a domain hosting service or something of that sort, and Paul's worked at a warehouse. The real question is dream jobs. And I suppose if I can add to that, say you won a couple of hundred million in the lottery, and you've got to do something with your spare time, otherwise you go mental. What would you do?
Oh, I don't know if that applies, because I was going to say I would love to be like an athlete, especially like a hockey player, because I love hockey and I want to play hockey.
There's a lockout right now.
Is there a Paralympic hockey team?
Shut up! If I won millions of dollars, I couldn't do that. So I don't like your addition to this question.
Of course you could.
No, because you have $1 million doesn't mean you have any physical talent. No,
you're a hockey player. You're already a millionaire. Whatever.
You're happy to do it without the $1 million, but
I would be a sports figure.
You've got $100 million. You've got the time to go and spend 8 hours a day in the gym.
Beef, do you really need to be a sports figure? I mean, you're already a sex icon. Why do you need both?
Oh.
Yes, this is saying if he wasn't YouTube famous.
I'd like to do like what Mitt Romney does, just have lots of money in the bank and just get to
run for president.
No, lose horribly. No, not that part. I would just like to have nothing I have to actually do, just like to have lots of money in the bank and it earn interest and it give it to me. I mean, I know they were so poor in college they had to sell some of their stock options. But that's
another story. Your dream job is no job.
Right. My dream job is no job at all.
Your dream job is to buy small companies and then run them into the ground and fire everybody.
No, I don't want to fuck families over and screw people over or anything like that. No.
Just individuals?
Yeah. No. I don't want to hurt anyone else.
Why are you changing your personality for this question all of a sudden?
What?
You're always telling us about how you want to hurt people.
How you want to become a home wrecker and all this. It's like,
I want to punch Pack Rat in the face.
Oh, yeah.
I heard he eats babies.
See, it's me? A dream
or
job,
Pack
right?
Rat? Which one? Both of us. Baby buffets. Bouncing baby buffets. That's what we'll call it.
They're delicious.
See, for me, ribs. If seen as a quote unquote dream job, I'd love to like run like an internet cafe, like a gaming cafe. I don't know. I've always liked that, and have like an actual. Because I mean, I've been to a couple of cafes. Like Canada sucks for this type. Like Canada sucks for gaming communities and everything. And one of the things I think would be cool is like having like, obviously all the consoles and PCs in this, and also having like a legitimate coffee place as well in there. I don't know.
Are internet cafes really needed anymore in North America?
Yeah.
No.
Like, do people need to go to internet cafes?
Have you still got phone boxes in the street?
No.
No?
We have, there's really? Not phone boxes, but there's telephones, yeah.
No, there's not.
Where?
No. We've gotten rid of those.
Not in Toronto. If you see one, in fact, every once in a while when I do see one, like at a subway station or something, which is like once a year, I marvel at it.
Okay,
like
no, some sort don't of, nitpick really at this. This is a dream job. This is a dream job. You can't nitpick at my dream job.
Well, see, no. I think the biggest problem is that once something becomes your job, kind of what we were talking about earlier, then it changes the whole thing and it's not fun anymore. Like, for instance, I went to culinary school and I enjoyed to cook, but I would not want to be a chef because it would ruin the whole experience. And I think that's the thing that that's the reason why I said I don't want anything. I just want to enjoy not having anything to stress about.
Today I learned Good went to culinary school.
Really? Chef Good fan art, please.
You just learned that? Yes. Actually, can we do this? Can we have a fan art of Good cutting off Beef's legs, seeing as he's Beef, and then making
and
something delicious out of it?
Yes.
Yes.
Let's not have that at all. How about a fan art of Good punching Pack Rat in the face?
No, that doesn't sound as awesome.
And eating babies with Pack Rat.
Anyways, guys, that's all the questions we have today. I'm just joking. Do your sign out there, Beef.
There's no sign out. Thank you guys for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed it.
If you have questions,
where do they send their questions?
At podcast@goodlp.com. And I'm not putting in the description because we'll just get spammed.
More.
All right. So yeah, see you next Monday or Tuesday.
Oh yeah, sorry for being late today. We ran into some issues. We should have talked about this at the beginning. But anyways, we love you guys.
We have lives.
Yeah, we love you, and we'll talk to you later. Bye bye.
Good horse people.